Hello, I'm Davia Chambers, and this week we're coming to you from Mandy Villa. It's a beautiful five-bedroom villa nestled snugly in the seaside village of Mount Irvine near the popular fishing village of Buku. We've got lots in store for you up ahead. Let's Talk Tobago starts now. United Nations hosts consultation on poverty. Senior citizens take up the role of members of the THA for one day at the Assembly Legislature, and Tobago is a perfect destination for filming. Let's Talk Tobago will be right back.
Hey, why don't you step into the Scarborough Library facility? It has all the knowledge of our land, people, and heritage that you just won't find online. The Scarborough Library facility is now open. Tobago Library Services. Information inspires innovation.
Mandy Villa is virtually tucked away at Glenick Terrace on the Mount Irvine Estate. Owned by Margaret and John Skerritt, it's the perfect spot if you're looking for a family getaway or you're seeking that quiet spot to vacation while still having all the amenities you need close by. This week's top story deals with the issue of poverty. An intervention by the United Nations is set to inform policies and develop programs to create a national poverty reduction strategy on this island. The team recently met in Tobago with other stakeholders to address poverty alleviation. Here's Crystal George with more.
Society's less fortunate people can often feel left out of national development. But a recent meeting among the THA, the Ministry of Social Development and Family Services, and the United Nations Development Programme, UNDP, was held to discuss strategies for reducing the impact of poverty on the island. It was important with a significant goal. The theme for the consultation was No One Left Behind, Fostering Collaboration to Combat Poverty. The theme for the session was carefully chosen.
The title for this consultation series was symbolically chosen to reaffirm Trinidad and Tobago's commitment to the Sustainable Development Goals, but more importantly, to focus our discussions today on developing a people-centered national poverty reduction strategy, which will generate solutions to the deprivations which inhibit the capacity of some citizens to improve their living conditions and their ability to contribute to their communities.
The ministry is adamant in ensuring that the poverty level in Trinidad and Tobago stays at a minimum. Its hope is to find strategies to ensure such.
Poverty and its effects is one of the core issues that our ministry must grapple with. In fact, it's our view that poverty is not a matter we can afford to place on the back burner given the current socioeconomic climate. And in this regard, ladies and gentlemen, as we seek to stabilize our economy, it's essential that we leave no one behind.
The Tobago House of Assembly has also expressed its determination to play its part in eradicating poverty in Trinidad and Tobago.
Let me just take the opportunity to again indicate to you that the Tobago House of Assembly will continue to partner in this process. It is in our self-interest so to do. And therefore, we do not expect that the relationship will end today after the session.
I'm Crystal George for Let's Talk Tobago.
Your first view of Mandy Villa is inviting and promises peace and tranquility. You're greeted by nature in front of the cottage-like architecture, which opens onto some quiet luxury. And Mandy Villa is an ideal location for anyone to relax, including seniors. Speaking of seniors, the Assembly Chamber hosted a lively debate last week, but it wasn't the usual THA session, as elderly Tobagonians had their say for the day. They used the opportunity to move a motion on issues affecting senior citizens. Here's how that turned out.
And whereas the Assembly ensures that all members of society are empowered to function to the best of their ability, and whereas the vulnerable, including the aged, receive protection consistent with their needs, and whereas senior citizens organizations in Tobago are strengthened.
That's the motion seniors from around the island debated at the Assembly Legislature.
I want to recommend that an education program be put in place to be factored into our school system, beginning from the kindergartens, going to the primary, and then to secondary schools. So that by the time, because I'm sure that all of us know that a young child in a kindergarten school, they possess a lot of love in them, eh? And if you begin to teach them at that point, from that point, to love and understand the problem of age and aging, that is going to remain in there.
The leader of government business added that since the THA ensures that the aged and vulnerable receive protection, a senior citizen's home should be constructed by the Assembly.
The government should own and run their own elderly citizens' home. Number two, that their caregivers should be trained or retrained to take care of Alzheimer patients, because they can be abusive. So you have to have love and understanding to take care of them. And number three, that the Assembly or the social services should take complaints from the elderly neighbors, just as the neighbors complain about child abuse.
That training, the member for Golden Lane Plymouth says, is of utmost importance.
We have things like verbal abuse, the derogatory remarks, the statements that they use, Madam Presiding Officer. We have to take cognizance of that. And I hope that when the time comes that this kind of treatment, verbal abuse and slang words, bad words, insulting words, is not meted us.
The inaugural debate was hosted by the Aging Unit of the Division of Health and Social Services. It's aimed at encouraging the senior citizens to contribute their wealth of knowledge and share their experiences. I'm Kern DeFreitas for Let's Talk Tobago.
The view from the villa is also fantastic. By day, it gets the shade of a glorious salmon tree, and for the golf enthusiasts, it overlooks the Mount Irvine Golf Course. It also offers guests a view of the Caribbean Sea. Now, this next story acknowledges the contributions made to the development of this little island by an extraordinary Tobagonian. When A&R Robinson passed away in 2014, he left behind a legacy for citizens to emulate. Well, one institution is shining a light on that said legacy through a lecture series. Here's Omidara Mills with more.
Arthur Napoleon Raymond Robinson. To date, he's the only person who's held the three highest public offices in Trinidad and Tobago. That's Chairman of the Tobago House of Assembly, Prime Minister and President. His willingness to serve went beyond this country, and he was instrumental in the establishment of the International Criminal Court. Many attribute his achievements to his character and his outlook on life.
That concern for rationality is for me very, very much a Robinsonian quality. When you read his work, he was eminently rational, constantly thinking things through. And when you read his work in the context of his own personal development, you realize how that rational thinking, right, was something that led to his own personal development as a human being.
The A&R Robinson Memorial Lecture Series was started last year by the Assembly Legislature Secretariat. The tribute is fitting since Mr. Robinson felt strongly about Tobago having greater autonomy over its affairs. His efforts led to the restoration of the Tobago House of Assembly as the governing institution for the island. The recently elected presiding officer of the Assembly Legislature, Vanessa Cutting Thomas, says Mr. Robinson even left his mark on the Secretariat's operations.
Assembly Legislature Secretariat is mandated by its mission to provide members of the Tobago House of Assembly with professional procedural support and efficient administrative services in a political manner in order that they may effectively perform their functions.
The lecture series is a way to remind people of the importance of fostering strong values, whether it's in politics, culture, law, or society. In discussing the attributes exemplified by Ms. Robinson, Reverend Clyde Harvey analyzed the speech he made on January 5th, 2001.
His enunciation of moral and spiritual values was rooted in his sense that the public good was primary. He says, "I have tried to set my sights and purposes to the public good." A life of service rooted in the public good is what he saw himself as about.
It's hoped that Mr. Robinson's character, his extensive contributions to the country's development, the fight for the island's self-governance, and global justice will be remembered by the people of this country. I'm Omidara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
On the other side of the break, Tobago is not just the perfect place for sun, sand, and sea. You'll find out more after this break. Don't touch that dial. Stay with Let's Talk Tobago.
From the turquoise waters of the Caribbean Sea, through lush tropical rainforest and picturesque seaside villages, to the rugged coast of the Atlantic Ocean on Tobago's East Coast, experience a destination marathon like no other. Sponsored by Flo and Republic Bank Limited. 4 races, 2 days, 1 finish line. The Tobago Sea to Sea Marathon, May 21st and 22nd, 2016. Come for the race, stay for the place. The possibilities are endless. Register now at sea2seamarathon.com and get ready to experience the beautiful challenge in Tobago.
Welcome back. Here in the dining room, the charm of Mandy Villa is apparent. High ceilings, cool tiled floors, and coral stone walls are easy to appreciate, especially with an abundance of natural light. It's the ideal area to enjoy the cool breeze while having a good time with friends and family. The clean, green, safe, and serene island of Tobago is known for its lush surroundings, blue oceans, and picturesque views. And those are only some aspects of the island that make it the perfect place for filming. Since the 1960s, Tobago has been opening its doors for international filmmakers. Movies like The Swiss Family Robinson, The Gauntlet 2, an American reality challenge show, and most recently, Tobago 1677 have all been shot here. Now Tobago plays home to another adventure reality show. Here's more from Juliet James.
The Bloody Bear River has been transformed for the filming of El Desafio, or Superhuman Challenge. Executive producer for Caracol TV, Marcelo Greco, says that Tobago offers the best stage for the Colombian TV show.
Incredible beaches, incredible places. And talking about logistics, we found a right place, okay, for this project to be made. It's possible to be made here. That's why we made the decision to come here.
The reality adventure is also being filmed at Bloody Bear Beach, Englishman's Bay, and Friendship Estate. Locals and visitors, however, can only access these areas when there is no filming taking place. Filming moves from each location every 3 to 4 days, which is why Caracol TV has enlisted Tobagonians to work alongside the Colombian crew.
We have a lot of locals working for us, helping us building these crazy structures, moving our stuff, moving our materials, driving ourselves because we have a lot of drivers, a lot of cars. Locals are basics. I mean, it's basic for our job, and they are the most important power that we have in our crew.
An important part of the filming is keeping the various sites clean at all times. That's a duty Mr. Mervyn McKnight takes seriously.
So I go to all the outlets, take up all the garbage, so I'm the last person to leave. We have to encourage tourism by all means. Everyone had to get on board and involved.
Getting on board and involved is Bloody Bear businessman Mr. Larry James, who provides local cuisine while the film crew is in the area.
We usually prepare is approximately 68 plates, right? And the local dishes is like, we'll have like fried fish, chicken, pork, but not samely, but you know, different days with some rice, rye planting, dashin, and potato, sweet potato.
The Reality Adventure Challenge El Desafio will be aired in 43 different countries from July. It will promote all the locations on the island that are being used for the reality show. From the Division of Tourism and Transportation, I'm Juliet James for Let's Talk Tobago.
One of the most appealing things about the interior of Mandevilla is its open plan, which gives this villa the feeling of endless space. The living area opens out onto a large patio that's perfect for al fresco dining. Remember last week we told you about the C2C marathon that's using the ocean view as the backdrop for its competition? Well, this week we have more to share with you about this internationally recognized tournament. The C2C marathon is more than just a competition. It's about reviving distance running on the island and getting young Tobagonians involved. Here's more in this story.
These youngsters, ages 9 to 21, are preparing for the first ever Tobago International C2C Marathon. Since February, they've participated in 7 sessions of a youth training camp designed to stimulate and sustain interest in cross-country running on the island. They learned about wearing the right type of clothing, running properly, having a proper diet, and preventing injuries.
If you educate them about, you know, eating energy drinks, not taking certain energy drinks before a race because that's going to damage your heart, you know. So this initiative was mainly for that purpose, dealing with injuries with young athletes. A lot of young athletes, they get injuries, sometimes not even knowing that they are injured, and continue to run and play sports on these injuries and making it worse.
They also practiced techniques for endurance, speed, stamina, and recovery. Most of these young people will take part in the 5K, with some challenging themselves to the 10K.
I like doing marathons because it's a good exercise for the body.
I'm expecting to finish in the top 5 and still have energy to run the next one.
More than 40 youngsters registered for the camp. The knowledge they gained has equipped them to go beyond the C2C marathon.
They will continue to train and maybe improve onto greater things. You never know, Olympics, different marathons in Trinidad and Tobago, in the region, in the world. Also, scholarships is another a benefit. Because of the knowledge they would have gained here, they could go on to actually gaining scholarships from their training.
The youth training camp, as well as the marathon, is supported by the Tobago House of Assembly. I'm Omidara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
Here at Mandevilla, there's also an outdoor patio that leads directly to the pool. Now, for any tourist visiting Tobago, it's more than enjoying their stay at beautiful villas or hotels. They can also experience Tobago's culture. That's why cultural expositions are important. In this next story, you'll hear about a cultural group that celebrated 21 years of existence and decided to share Tobago's traditions with everyone at an open location. Here's more.
Tobago's indigenous culture was exposed once more as the Culture Club Ensemble celebrated its 21st anniversary. The club created a showcase featuring traditions of the island at the Gulf City Mall Lowlands.
In this time when popular cultural expressions seems to be occupying the minds of our youth more than our indigenous culture, a culture that has developed through blood, sweat, and tears of those that went before us, our ancestors. Our ancestors laid the foundation for our way of life and how we interact with each other today.
So they danced. Formed a mixture of African and Caribbean rhythms on instruments, and delivered dramatic presentations.
You know it, man, sing it. Aye, aye, aye.
Honey, like, I told you, I don't know any of those songs.
Robert, what you're saying is that you don't believe in my culture, Robert? Or culture?
Honey, not our culture. Maybe yours, and I hope you change it.
Robert, did you ever had any intentions of marrying me?
Honey, sometimes you ask the stupidest questions possible. Of course I do.
So when we have children, Robert, you wouldn't want them to experience the same culture that we experience?
Oh, no, 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 no. No, honey. Not under my roof. You see, when we have children, I want them to go ballet classes, violin lessons, and experience the world.
What happened to all folk songs, Robert, or all belly dances?
The Culture Club Ensemble is managed by Jesse Taylor. It's aimed at preserving the island's traditions. I'm Keyshawn Wilson for Let's Talk Tobago.
Coming up, will you live to see 100? While that's not certain, you'll see one man who did. Let's Talk Tobago will be right back. Stay with us. If you're a lover of nature and the outdoors, you've got it all at Mandi Villa. Not only does it stretch onto the Mount Irvine Golf Course, but some of the island's most popular beaches are just a short walk or drive away. Now this next story takes us away from Mount Irvine to the village of Pembroke, where Tobago's newest centenarian was celebrated in fine style. Take a look.
Rupert Derrick is Tobago's newest centenarian, and his 100th birthday was celebrated in fine style at the Pembroke Community Center, surrounded by family, friends, and well-wishers. He, who was born and raised in the village of Pembroke, was a businessman for most of his life and was also largely involved in the agricultural sector. The centenarian attributes his long life to hard work and faith in God.
Well, I know from a young coming up in the world, right? I believe in one God, walking and praying. And I work hard in life. Agriculture work with my father in Pembroke Estate. Right? And I'm a businessman and all kind of things from a small. And I live a clean life.
A dedicated family man, Mr. Derrick was married with 4 children and continued to raise his grandchildren into his senior years, imparting his knowledge of the world onto them. His great-nephew, Dwight Hunt, said it was a joy to witness his uncle become part of the centenarian club, stating that throughout the many years of interactions they have had, he has indeed learned much from him.
His life has been one that he usually teaches. In all his experiences, he's always passed it down to us. And for some reason, his jovial spirit would always make you gravitate to him, because, I mean, you know, a lot of youths don't really want to pay that much attention to the elder folks. But he has a charisma about him that could make you sit down and listen to him.
Rupert now lives with his niece, Claudia Hunt, in Trinidad. Hunt grew up as a member of his household and expressed joy at seeing him reach this milestone.
Ecstatic, happy. You know, I didn't believe that I would have lived. Not him, you know, but I would have lived to see this day. It's really a joy, a real, real joy. I feel blessed.
She thanked the Division of Community Development and Culture for assisting the family and recognizing the centenarian on such an auspicious occasion. And being the profoundly spiritual person that he is, Mr. Derrick had a word of advice to all of us living in Trinidad and Tobago.
God will take care of me, and let me take care of you too. Pray without ceasing.
From the Division of Community Development and Culture, I'm Kimberly Job for Let's Talk Tobago.
If you want to cool down or simply unwind, there's a large freeform swimming pool and a jacuzzi. Whether indoors or outdoors, Mandevilla translates to relaxation. It takes hard work, dedication, and money to run volunteer organizations. But sometimes enough money isn't raised through their own efforts, so they turn to benefactors. Omidara Mills tells us more.
This is just one of the activities for young people at the Moriah Police Youth Club. The club has been around for a number of years, but the recent relaunch and awards ceremony signaled its revitalization and renewed thrust towards community building.
We have really good response, especially from the children's side. Parents are more involved now. Other persons in the community are willing to come on board. Since the relaunch of the Moriah Police Youth Club, we had a lot of good feedback so far.
Support for the relaunch came from the Office of the Chief Secretary. Ms. Samaru applauds the Chief Secretary's efforts to assist NGOs like the Moriah Police Youth Club.
It's a nice gesture that he volunteers to help because, to be honest, being a non-profitable organization, it is very challenging. Sometimes you do fundraising, but you don't always get back that profit that you want. So the little that the Chief Sec will offer to you, it goes a long way. You just have to know how to manage your funds.
The Tobago United Spiritual Baptist Assembly is another organization that received financial support. They hosted the Spiritual Baptist Liberation Day celebrations and the launch of their 2016 outreach program.
We would have faced challenges if we did not get that funding to assist the amount of people or the amount of institutions that we do assist, you know. For example, in Tobago, we have like about 6 homes for the aged, eh? And we visit all of them. We distribute foodstuff, toiletries, and, you know, that sort of thing. And then to bring the Spiritual Baptist youth together, to let them know, well, what the organization, what it's all about, to enlighten them, you know, it's quite a task. So we need the funding.
The assistance helps these volunteer groups continue to improve the lives of many Tobagonians. I'm Omidara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
It's Have Your Say time, and we want to hear some of your thoughts on this week's topic. We took to the streets to find out, what areas do you think your community can most improve? Here's what you had to say.
The area I think that needs to be more developed in my community is the roads, and we need some community centers, maybe a library and those things.
I think they need to utilize the community centers and take off the youths off the streets.
Moriah is my area and the field needs improvement. It needs to be properly maintained regularly, as well as they need to have toilet facilities.
The roads need to be fixed because I think that is why the fees raised to go to Mount St.
John. I'm from Mason Hall, and I think that the areas that need to be improved are the health center, the park, and the football field.
The community center, the toilets are not functioning properly.
In Adventure, we would like to have our roads improved. We would like to have an improved frequency to our water supply.
The roads, and we should need some more play park for children and our library, especially so that they can read.
As always, we thank you for watching. Remember, you can email us your comments or queries about the program, and be sure to visit our website, like us on Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. From our house to yours, I'm Davia Chambers, along with the Department of Information, Office of the Chief Secretary, Tobago House of Assembly, wishing you a safe and productive week. As we go, we leave you with a short montage from the Tobago Games hosted by the Special Olympics of Trinidad and Tobago. I know a sad story.